Welcome to the Your Little Castle Show, where we highlight the best experts that make your home into your little castle. Let's go! Welcome everyone to another episode of the Your Little Castle Show. Buddy of mine for a long time now, Bobby Pointer in the building. Bobby, welcome to the Your Little Castle studio.
Thank you, Carter. Appreciate it.
Well, as a leader in the community, somebody I've known you for quite a long time now, as a professional building, helping make this community the best that it is. Tell me what it is you love most about what you do with your business. So everybody, this is Best Roofing and Exteriors, and your family deserves the best.
That's right. There's a lot of fly-by-night roofers out there. They come in town on these hailstorms.
Yeah, I've seen that happen.
Yeah, it happens. They build a sloppy roof. You can't get a hold of them anymore. We're local people, been local all our lives. My dad was in construction. We want the best product at a great price for the consumer.
Well, that is an elementary piece. You'd think that would be something that everybody would want for their clients, but how often do we have? I've seen some of the work some of those guys have done, and they don't last.
Right.
Somebody like yourself, been in business now 20 years. You've proven that you can handle this and make it happen. Why did you decide you wanted to get into the roofing business? You talked about your dad a little bit. Was he kind of the impetus behind that? And you're saying, hey, if dad can do this, man, I think I can carry on the torch.
I think it's because the house, the foundation is very important, but now the roof is very important too. You know the old saying, you need to have a roof over your head. Well, this is the truth. You have a problem with your roof, you have a problem with your whole house. Leaks inside, damage to your house, damage to your furniture. It's one of the most important parts.
Well, and if you don't have a substantial roof over your head, then you're looking for, like I said, a lot of people don't realize the problems that occur. Talk a little bit about that, because I know we got a specific set of things I want to make sure we cover, but very specific to roofing. You start getting water down the insides, it gets behind the fascia and the siding, and then you've got mold. I mean,
right.
These are big problems that people don't realize, and you need an expert that can help identify that kind of stuff.
You do, especially if your house, you know, you get a new house, you're happy to move in, they do roof inspections, but behind the roof is the fascia, behind the metal is the wood, it gets rotted all the time. You see the water coming off the roof. If there's a hole in your roof, there's not flashed properly, it goes in the house. You don't know what's going in there until you have black mold. Big danger for kids, big danger for people. We see this all the time, that there's black mold behind the walls.
Yeah, that mold, I've seen that myself. I'm not going to give any specifics, but one of the houses I was connected to, if you will, we were working on it, and we get behind whatever just to help out with the family, friends, and we go, what is this stuff? This looks terrible. And this can cause major detriment. And it's a lot to do because it was poor installation, is that right?
Poor installation, poor materials, poor flashing. The little things that make a big difference. You get water inside that house, it is a problem. It's one of the biggest things. Water makes huge problems, makes huge devastation to houses. Look, water made the Grand Canyon. Look at that.
That's a good point. There's a lot of people who may not realize that whole thing was carved out by a steady flow of consistent water. It wasn't like an ocean through there. It was a little river.
Over time, water will destroy.
Okay. So what was the path? I mean, when you woke up one day, your dad had done this, you said, I want to get into this. Did you start off as a kid working on roofs, or where were you at when you developed your passion for this?
As old as I am, when you grow up, you work with your dad when you're young. Right. That's the way it was. We worked with dad on all the projects. After high school, I went into the military, served my country for about 6 years active, the rest of the time reserve. And then I got out of active and I wanted to do something with my dad. Wanted to do construction. He was good at it. He takes care of families. I thought, you know, let's give this a try.
Well, if that's the kind of background, especially with the military background, thank you for serving our country, because there's a lot of people that do get into the roofing side of this and they don't have that discipline. I think the discipline that most people, I was not as fortunate, but it's almost like I lived in a military house. My parents were strict. But you find a lot of these kids, if they don't have that kind of a background, that right. is something that helps give that guidance. It gives that discipline to stay on task. So 6 years in the military, did they help you learn a little bit about how to function on this little planet?
They help with a lot of things. You know, you're an 18-year-old kid. You don't go to college because maybe your family doesn't have enough money. The military is a great start for everybody. You know, you learn a lot of things in the military. You meet a lot of people. I still talk to people from the military that I was served with on a weekly basis.
And well, and I tell you, those are some of the connections you'll make for a lifetime, that the friends you'll keep for a lifetime.
Right.
Kind of like, for me, it was a few of the guys in college and some of the guys I played baseball with. It's kind of like a fraternity when you're in the military.
It is. You depend on these people. You know, you depend on them every single day. One of my good friends, Don Gelinas, he lives up in Boston. I had to call him the other day when the Boston Celtics, you know, were nicked out of the playoffs there. So they did real good. But, you know, we still jab each other. I call him all the time, visit him when I can. We have reunions still, and this is over 20 years ago.
20 years ago, and still good connections.
Still good.
And the Celtics, we've got
Mr. Hometown Tatum, boy.
Jason Tatum.
Yep, hometown boy.
Doing some fun stuff here in St. Louis. Well, that's very neat. I'm going to put up on for everybody to take a look at it. You've got a great-looking little website we got here. We're going to scroll back up to the top of this. BestRoofSTL.com. That's a heck of a domain.
Yeah.
You got it. Well,
good domain.
You are the best.
We looked for a long time to get that domain.
Spent lots of time and energy.
Spent lots of time.
Figuring that out. It's amazing to me that you got it. Good looking site here.
We have another site in progress, too. We're building it bigger and better. More friendly, user friendly. You'll be able to, you know, put your information better, better contact. The whole thing's going to be better.
Mobile friendly, all those.
Very much so.
I'm going to surprise you a little bit here. First off, let me, when I do this, let me put up on the screen. I want everybody, so we'll keep talking here, but I can make the computer take over the screen. So I'm going to take off our display there for our TV stuff. And you can see us there. And let me show you when we get down here. Look at this, everybody. Best Roofing and Exteriors, 4.9. This is Home Advisor, 4.9. You had one person that didn't give you a 5, I guess.
You know, we do get some complaints as part of the business. You know, we do 45, 50 projects every month. You're going to get somebody that complains. The biggest thing is you have to go back out there, fix the problem, fix whatever issue it is. Just today we had a problem. It was a small project. It was a fence, but it's an exterior. And they didn't like the way it was set up. So I sent guys out there to fix it today. You have to make sure you get back out there. You're going to make mistakes. That's part of life. You have to stay in contact and fix your problems.
Yeah, that's a key to life. A lot of people, we're on a little bit of a unique perspective from what we normally talk about. But man, life is about, it doesn't matter what kind of business you have, what kind of, what you're trying to accomplish. My dad used to use this quote for baseball. It's not the error in the game that causes you to lose the error. It's how you respond to that error.
Right.
And somebody, that's a great point you make, because a lot of business people we talk to in the studio here, we miss that point, I think, sometimes, and it's a great one to make, because there is inevitable. There's nothing that ever gets done that's perfect.
Right. In construction, it's that way. You're gonna make a mistake. They're not gonna be happy. Something's gonna be wrong. You need to go back and fix it. You need to make it right.
Well, that's cool to hear you say, because somebody with 20 years of experience, you've had to have had a bunch of problems that you had to deal with. Even if it was just miscommunication.
Right.
They brought
usually my fault.
but you go off and you admit it and you take it. Right. Priority to get it fixed. That's important. All right, so tell me an objection that you normally face. When somebody's saying, I really want you guys to do the work on my house, but tell me why we should use you guys. And what's one objection somebody says, I got to think about it. And you're like, well, let me help you understand what you're really talking about with that. How do you help people to be at peace within their own mind?
The biggest thing is I can show them hundreds and hundreds of houses we do. I can show them the work. I can give them the name of referrals. But I think best is that their most objective point is the price of a new roof. Roofs are expensive. Yeah. You know, doing work's expensive. Lumber's up. Metal's up. Everything's up. It's expensive. But we do a majority of storm claims. And the insurance company, we work with them very well. They pay for a lot of that rehab of the roof, inside work, things like that. The insurance company is there to help you. People are afraid that if they file a claim, they're going to have a problem down the road with it. That's not true. It's an act of God. You need to get it fixed. Why not have the insurance company help you out?
Well, a lot of people don't understand. That is a great point, that the insurance companies, they're in it to make money too. They're a business that's designed to obviously keep in business and keep providing the insurance they need to for people. But how important is it to have an expert like yourself? How often can an individual homeowner say, I'll go on and take on the insurance company. I can handle this.
That's a great question. About 95% of the roofs that I go on or one of my guys go on, while the inspector's out there, it gets bought by the insurance agent. There's one insurance company around that doesn't want to buy any roofs. I'm not going to name any names. I'm sure everybody knows who it is.
I've heard of them. Yes.
You know, they're a biggie, but they don't want to buy roofs. But if I go out there and meet with the adjuster, chances are we'll get the roof bought if there's damage. I won't waste anybody's time if I don't see the damage. I'm not going to go out there and waste their time, the homeowner's time, my time. So when I go out there on the roof, we get most of the roofs bought.
And that's the key, because how do you as a owner, like I do internet, I do television, but how am I going to decipher whether a roof has enough damage?
Right.
I've worked with a buddy of mine for a long time. He's been a good friend for a little while. He's like, come out, work with me. I need a little help. And he taught me a little bit. But man, there's a lot to learn. There's a lot of expertise. And this isn't something you just pick up in like 6 weeks and you go, oh, by the way, I can get your roof done for you.
Right.
There's years of experience. What are some of the caveats that you think you bring to the table that can help people feel comfortable, understand they need an expert like yourself?
I've worked on roofs. I've carried shingles on roof. I've flashed roof. I've fixed roof. I've put whole apartment complex roofs on. We just finished an apartment complex up in Hazelwood. And in Hazelwood, unlike most places around town, you need permits. You have to have the inspector come out there. Not only the adjuster look at the roof, you have to have the inspector come out there on every phase of the roof. So this is what we do best.
Well, somebody who's done it like that, I didn't realize you'd actually done the work to do the construction.
Oh, yeah.
That adds a lot to it, because when you've actually put the pieces in place, it's like I can tell somebody how to use a computer, but to decipher what's wrong with it, you have to have been somebody who's actually built a computer to really understand.
I put a lot of shingles on. I put a lot of drip edge on. I put a lot of roofing on. Fixed a lot of problems that people had up there, but I don't do much of the work anymore myself. I'm getting a little old for that.
Right.
You know, and I have a 2.5-year-old daughter I need to get home to every night.
Absolutely. And we've got a cute picture of you and her. We got the right title. There it is. Bobby Poynter, ladies and gentlemen, president, owner, and dad. And so there is a little picture of you and your daughter on the, I guess that's a, is that one of the merry-go-rounds?
At the zoo.
That's what at the zoo.
With some good friends of ours, we took her to the zoo a couple months ago, and it was her first experience at the zoo. And that's the thing she liked the most, was the merry-go-round. She liked the animals, but the merry-go-round is what really did it for her.
The merry-go-round. Well, that's what we said. Now you're doing some good stuff that makes me proud to see another fellow St. Louisan. So we put the Cardinal Cowboy hat on you, because we want to emphasize the leaders in our community. They're making a difference. And not only are you a businessman, but you're also a family man.
Yes.
And somebody that takes it from all sides to make sure that you're doing the best for the community here, not just a guy who puts on roofs, but also has a family that can knows how to deal with what's going on to make a happy family.
Yeah, we grew up in Ferguson and moved out to St. Charles, St. Peter's. My dad took a job out there, and we've been out here for over 30 years.
30 years living in the area, doing what you do. Were you born in St. Louis?
Ferguson.
Ferguson, you said? Okay, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And so as a matter of being in the north part of St. Louis, do you work in the south? Is there any particular area that you say, this is where we like best, or you just say, all of St. Louis? I mean,
well, I tell you what, we do a lot of work in North County. There's some older homes up there.
Okay.
We do a lot of work in Wildwood. The roofs are bigger in Wildwood. The money's better in Wildwood. I hate to be that way, but it's the truth, you know, bigger roofs, you know, you're out there making a roof look nice, but we do every roof. We did a roof in O'Fallon. It was about a 12 square roof, little bitty one.
Really?
But the lady had an insurance company that wouldn't buy the whole roof. So we did the second half of the roof for free for her, but she needed a roof done. Turned out, though, her daughter owned a commercial building. We did their roof, too. So
yeah, that's kind of how it works. You work for the little jobs, and they refer you to the big guys.
Every little job works.
And do what's right to help people do what they need to do to get the proper house, and then helping people at all shapes and sizes, even if 12 square.
That's a little bitty house.
That's a little bitty house. But
right.
Hey, when you do it right, you get that referral, and somebody says, hey, man, doing good work. What really fuels your passion? I mean, what is it when you wake up every day, you're going, this is cool. I mean, it's neat to put a roof on somebody's house, but is it more about I'm helping to protect a family? It's the household. It's where they're going to raise their kids. What is it you enjoy most about what
you're doing? I'm an early riser. I'm up by about 5:15 every morning. You know, I mean, in the construction business, you kind of have to be. But what really the most important thing in my world is my daughter, of course, right now. She wakes up a little bit after I do. She comes downstairs. We eat breakfast together. But putting roofs on, I think it's a big thing. I really do. There's so many problems. You hear so many problems with roofs, leaks. Once in a while, we still have a leak. We go out there, we fix it. It's a good industry to be in. Like, you always hear the things about used car salesmen.
Right.
I know some good used car salesmen.
Sure.
Same thing with roofers. There's good roofers out there. There's a bunch of good roofers. But there's some bad ones, too.
Right. And somebody with the experience that you've had, as long as you've been doing this, it's hard to be a bad roofer and last as long as you have
right.
to do this for so long. So I think that's a good point a lot of people need to understand. 30 years working on it, 20 years owning your own business.
Right. I think it's important. We don't do a lot of advertising. This was kind of big for us because we don't do advertising. We don't have these big billboards. We don't have these TV commercials. Ours is word of mouth, friends telling friends, family members telling family members, hey, call Bobby. He does a great job. We just got a call today for a concrete job, and we're doing their sister's concrete and their mother's concrete. Word of mouth is the biggest advertiser if you do it right.
Well, I would say if you develop a business based on word of mouth, then you're going to have good luck because that's what people trust most.
Right.
And when somebody can sit down in front of you, and that's really why we enjoy this format. And I wanted to invite you to be on our show because when you get a chance to just sit down really and talk to somebody and say, hey, let's give a full-blown description, a full-blown explanation of how we can really help. Explain what it is we do. Not just a 15-second splash and, hey, we're in front of you. This is pretty cool. But let me talk about why somebody should use your services because you've been doing this for so long. So I'm really glad you came in the studio to talk about that. What do you personally do to contribute, or what does your company do most to contribute to the community? If you had to say one thing you really love most, and I love the part, just the roof is so important.
It is important. But like I said, we give the extra. Everybody wants to beat the insurance company up and beat the people up for upgrades on shingles. We put GAF shingles on, made in America. They support the military. We give them free upgrade for that. We don't have to. We pay more for them. But it's a better product. Makes the roof look better. Makes us look better. We go the extra. We work on the skylights. We make sure it's flashed properly. We go to the extra without charging the customer more.
Well, that's important because a lot of people do get worried about, hey, how much money are they going to stick with me here? Because I know when I'm talking about a roof, it's right. not a $2,000 deal usually. It's you're talking, generally you're looking at something that's going to start at like $6,000 or $7,000 on the low end. And these roofs can go $30,000, $40,000, $50,000.
Easily.
That's a major investment. Why would you say somebody should be so, what are they sacrificing when they are saving money per se because they're not spending much, but they're not getting what they need? What are some of the gaps they may be missing when they're getting a roof put on that they don't realize are important?
I think it's important to use the right materials. Like I said, GAF is a great shingle company. They support the military. They put a 40-year guarantee on their product. They don't come off the roof. You know, they're tested high wind. They're a great product. We start with that. We try to use nothing but GAF because we feel it's the best product in the market.
Well, and I'm very familiar with GAF, and they have specific programs set up to make sure that the stuff gets done right. And
right.
They have the pieces in place so that you are testing and appropriate qualifications to make sure that roof is done right. And so when you're working with a supplier like GAF, so they're your primary go-to.
They are my go-to. We went to a training seminar last week or the week before for them, and I've been doing this a long time, but there were some things that I didn't remember. You know, sometimes you forget stuff. So these training seminars they put out are very important. They're there to help you. So they help us. We help the consumer. We get a better product, we get a better roof, we have less problems.
Less problems, that's what everybody's looking for, because when you have problems with a roof, they can get very expensive. Like we talked about, for the people that might have missed the beginning of the show, when you got leaks and problems with the roof, it's not just the roof and the subsurface underneath the roof in the
right.
attic. It runs down the house, causing it can cause foundation problems. Is that true?
It can. Everything that water destroys, it goes through a path. It can go all the way down to the foundation, the ceiling, the inside. You get mold behind the walls. You have to make sure your roof is leak-free. Like I said, once in a while, you're going to find a leak. We come back, we fix the problem. A lot of it's flashing. A lot of it's sometimes the wind blows something off. But we come back, we fix the problem. No charge. We want to be out there. We want to come back to the house one time, put a roof on, and go about our business. If there's a problem, we more than happily come back and fix it.
That's important too. How many companies like you're talking about, they do show up because they see a storm. They drive to St. Louis. Right. They're going to take care of whatever it is, right, for now.
Right.
And then when you have that problem, you're going, wait a minute, somebody come back, and they're not there to help.
Right.
And a lot of even companies that necessarily they're in St. Louis, but they don't last.
Right.
Somebody that's been around as long as you, that can be a little more comforting for the
company. It is. And too. I want to go to Deerberg's, and I run into somebody. I want a good experience when I run into somebody I did work for. And that's just the way it is. You know, I'm going to be here the rest of my life. My family's here. So, you know, we better do a good job.
Well, let's talk about St. Louis a little bit, and a little bit of the fun part of your life. When you say, this is the one thing I love doing for fun, we talked a little bit about it, but I'll let you explain. What do you do for fun in St. Louis?
Big baseball fan.
Baseball.
Big surprise there, huh?
Is that something kind of neat? Yep. That most people, I say, you almost have to be a Cardinal fan in St. Louis. It's hard to survive.
Right.
People come in from out of town, and I love greeting them. I'm like, thanks, you guys, for Cubs fans. We appreciate all the work you've done to help us win all these
right.
rings. But I mean, we're really a family over here. Something you mentioned to me about why you like the Cardinals. You remember that discussion we had before?
They're always in contention.
Always
they're never out of it. They're always able to go to the, you know, the playoffs. They're a solid team. And they don't spend as much money as the big teams do. People want to play here for less money. It's a better place. It's, what, baseball heaven?
Baseball heaven right here in St. Louis, Missouri, everybody. Well, I'm just excited to have you on the show to talk about this, guys, because that is kind of a motivation. And I tie the perspective that the Cardinals have together, if you will, to say, hey, we don't spend the most money. We don't put all kinds of resources towards flashy stuff. It's just a matter of we're going to home grow our talent. We're going to have a better attitude. I think there's a superior attitude. And is that something that ties into when you've got a business, you need to have that kind of attitude of this is going to get done. We're going to do it right. We're going to make sure it's done right the first time. And this is kind of the approach the Cardinals have. And I think that ties into why the success of a lot of businesses.
I think so, too. If you're going to look at the baseball world, the Cardinals are a mid-market team. And that's kind of like a small business compared to the Yankees and, you know, the California teams.
Right.
So we're a small business. You know, we're not a big business. My nephew works with us. My family works with us. I've been working with guys on our crews for 14 years. So they come to my house. It's a big family. Same thing with the Cardinals. Big family, big friends. You know, taking care of business.
I like that. That's a great point you make there because, yeah, it is essentially we are one big family in St. Louis. They joke about don't go too far from one side of the city to the other because everybody knows somebody who knows somebody. You know, what right. high school did you go to? And there'll be somebody and say, I know that guy, and here's what you should be proud of to know and work with that guy. But if anybody ever takes advantage of somebody, well, that spreads fast too.
Quicker.
It keeps you from lasting 20 or 30
yeah.
years like you.
Quicker.
So that's why if you've made it that long, another kudo to that fact. Well, the high ratings you've got are amazing. That's really important. I saw you actually have, I'm going to put up on the screen for everybody here, your BBB. Is that all right if I
yeah,
show people?
Yeah, that's fine.
That's I found that for you. And so everybody take a look at the screen behind us here. This is a really important rating because the Better Business Bureau does their evaluation and you do not get the kind of ratings that you see here unless you have earned it. And I'd say to have an A, as you can see right there on the screen, I'm going to go ahead and put that up on the wall for everybody too. But I mean, really, how important is it that you get that high rating? I've seen companies up there who did not have the rating that they would have preferred to have. And if you've got anything in the B's, C's, and D's,
right.
and F's, some definitely, but we've got that A.
Right, we also have good ratings on the Better Business Bureau. You're always gonna get someone who complains, that's the way it is. We've been doing it a long time. If you don't have somebody who complains, you're not doing that many jobs. The thing is, you gotta go out there and fix that job. No one really wants to write a good review, but we still get them. People write good reviews on our Google, on our BBB. We get a lot of good reviews.
That's important. So take note, everybody. So we've seen a 4.9 rating on HomeAdvisor. I found the Google ratings here, and I've got you on there for that too. Those are dynamite, also.
Right.
That's really tough, man. And everybody, like you said, you get one person, man, they will tell everybody.
Oh, yeah.
And it's hard to get people. But when you've got anything over a 4 is astounding. You're mid 4.3.
You'd have to worry about someone who has 5 out of 5. You kind of worry maybe you know, fix that, but no, those are real reviews.
Yeah, I was going to say, take a look at these reviews, everybody, and this is goes to show that when you have put it together, you're not just, this isn't some pumped up thing. There isn't a straight 5.0. If you end up with a 5.0, like you said, that's when you need to, there's a red flag there.
Right.
But in this case, yeah, you've got people giving in-depth reviews. You look at the amount of verbiage that people are taking the time to write here. This means that they really are interested in sharing their thoughts. And I would imagine that, yeah, like you say, you got to have enough in the, if you're in the mid fours, you are certainly doing your job on Google, because that's where all the brutal hanging people.
That's
hang
where they let it. That's they where let they it, let it out on you.
They let it be known for sure. And something to definitely make sure that you're going to be on top of. All right. So we've got good reviews. We know you love St. Louis. You love living here. Tell me, is there one favorite quote that you think kind of helps inspire you when you think about, because for me it was, if you think you can, or if you think you can't,
right?
You are correct. Do you have any particular thing that just kind of motivates you that you kind of live by?
Well, my dad always said it, you have to get up early, you have to work hard. So work ethic is the biggest thing in our life. I'm out there, I'm working tonight, I'll be working tomorrow, I'll be working this weekend. So the work hard is the biggest thing for me. It's not a phrase, but work hard, and all good things come to that.
I think there's a lot of phrases that do come from that, because if you're showing it, I was just having this discussion with my mom, not to get too emotional or too particular, but you know, we all go through times where business is up and business is down, but it's that consistency that comes out of it. How does the consistency appear? Because of the work,
right?
You just, every day you wake up, I know you and I are talking all the time about, hey, let's talk about this. Let's talk about this little thing we need to get together. And it's constant all day long, all night long. Ladies and gentlemen, if you want to get a hold of Bobby, he's available. I would venture to say not quite 24/7, because you do have to sleep a couple hours a day.
Right.
I would assume. But every time I hit you up, sometimes 8 or 9 o'clock at night, you're there.
Usually I'm working on the computer at that time.
That's when you have to put in the extra work.
Right. Unless you bill out the people, they won't pay you. So it's important to do those bills.
Right. Yeah, that's one of the things that we don't enjoy as much, because you got to sit there and go, I got to ask for the money from these people.
Right.
But being somebody that's been doing it for so long, they're paying you, because they appreciate the work that you're doing. Because
right.
It's a good quality.
They don't mind. You know, they don't mind. If you do a good job, they don't mind paying you, because our prices are most cheaper than most other people. So you do a good job, you give them a good price, give them a good product. You know, it's very important.
Keep that overhead low and get a high quality product.
I agree.
And that's something I notice about your business. You're not one of these big companies that puts yourself all over the place. You're going right to it.
You've got word of mouth.
A crew that you work with that helps make it happen. And then obviously the work to show it. Well, everybody, check it out. If you go to bestrooftl.com, I'll put that up on the screen for everybody, but you can see the shortcut we've got to the website. There it is. Bobby Pointer, as you can see, sitting next to me here in our studio. Best Roof STL, owner, founder, over 20 years doing this.
Doesn't your family deserve the best?
Doesn't your family deserve the best? And I'd say without that, there are problems that you will likely run into, because when you subjugate quality and don't do it the right way, you pay for it later.
You do.
And especially when you're talking about a $10,000, $20,000, $30,000 roof,
right,
that can cause the value of the house to diminish, then you're really talking about some problems.
I agree.
All right, everybody, thanks you guys for staying tuned here to the Your Little Castle show. We'll be back for more follow up with Bobby here. Bobby Pointer, president owner, Best Roof and Exteriors, bestroofstl.com. And we're looking forward to having some more fun with you on our show here, and fun stuff we do in our community.
Thanks, Carter.
Is that right?
Yes, sir.
All right, everybody, be back for more. Stay tuned. This is the Your Little Castle Show.